everyone. My name is Roselyn Karambakua from Nelson Mandela University in South Africa. The co-author is Professor Ronnie Ncwadi. He is also my promoter. I am a research fellow at the university. The title of my presentation is Developing a Framework for Managing Household Debt, the Case of South Africa. The outline is as follows. I'll start with the introduction, followed by objectives, methodology, literature. Then I'll outline the causes of household debt crisis in South Africa and the effects also. I'll also explain the framework that we developed for managing household debt and end with conclusions. So the composition of household debt to disposable income in South Africa is very high, and this signifies over-indebtedness of households. Ultimately, the welfare of the households is reduced, and the growth in repayment default is a challenge to the credit sector and the economic stability as a whole. And South Africa's middle class is facing a massive debt problem, and many of the people are borrowing for necessities such as food and transport, while on average, those in bad debt spend about 63% of their after-tax income on repayments. And the worst time credit defaults for personal loans in the country are mostly young or single cohabiting couples who are reliant on social grants. And normally these live in two-roomed informal dwellings. So given that background, the objectives of this paper are to understand the nature and determinants of household debt, and also to come up with a framework for managing household debt problem in South Africa. This will ensure a reduction in the debt burden amongst households and also reduce the negative impact of excessive debt on the economy as a whole. This paper highlights the impact of social security grants also on household debt. In terms of the methodology that we used a systematic literature review with consideration of both international and South African literature, and we identify and synthesize existing literature on household debt in an unbiased way to provide evidence for policy making. We also did a clear and comprehensive overview of available evidence on household debt. And the advantage of systematic literature review is that it enhances and promotes evidence-informed policy making. In addition to systematic literature review, we also did document analysis and secondary data analysis. So this paper is based on the life cycle hypothesis, and also the hypothesis suggests that households plan consumption and savings over their life cycle, and they opt for large amounts of debt in order to smoothen their consumption. The hypothesis also suggests that households have a negative savings rate during the early stages of working life, but these savings increase while indebtedness decreases as they grow older. So the composition of debt in South Africa is as shown here, whereby the majority of debt is in the form of mortgages at 52%, followed by secured credit agreements at 22%, and finally short-term credit at 0.2%. So this is the composition of household debt in South Africa. And most of the household debts is from the banking sector at 83%, followed by retailers constitute 2%, then non-bank financiers 5%, and then other credit providers, they follow the banking sector at 10%. And in the case of South Africa, unsecured loans grew by more than 53% between 2010 and 2011. Hence, there is concern also by policymakers as these unsecured loans continue to increase faster than disposable income pay households. And South Africa's household debt level actually reached 86.4% of personal disposable income in 2008, following the global financial crisis. But the ratio decreased slowly to 74.7% in the first quarter of 2012. So the following diagram shows the household debt to income ratio over the period 2011 to 2020. So like I have explained, it was 79.8% 2011, falling to 78.5% in 2015, reaching 71.9% 2018. And in 2020, it was standing at 77.1%. But now, the ratio is on an upward trajectory, as shown on this diagram, which is quite worrisome. So what are the causes of this household debt crisis in South Africa? Both demand and supply side factors account for the high household debt, and these include overall decrease in interest rates, greater financial inclusion post-apartheid, lack of financial education, debt contracts that are vague and reckless, and also reckless lending by financial intermediaries. So these are the causes of household debt crisis. So the indebtedness of households has been worsened also by natural disasters such as drought, floods, and also pandemics that South Africa has faced, such as HIV, AIDS, and recently the COVID-19 pandemic. So these have caused reduced capacity to repay loans as people's capacity to generate income has been drastically reduced. So South Africa is amongst the countries with the highest income inequalities also in the world. And income inequality exacerbates the problem of household debt. Other causes, there are also macroeconomic variables such as consumption, housing prices, inflation, unemployment also, which determine household debt. So managing household debt, given these aspects, is necessary for poverty reduction and also economic growth. And South Africa was found to have the lowest number of economically literate people and second lowest number of financially literate people based on a survey which was carried out of 50 countries. So it highlights a serious lack of necessary skills and knowledge to manage finance. There have been measures implemented to provide consumers with required skills and knowledge to understand the changing financial market and also to protect the already over indebted households whilst also preventing reckless credit granting. So these several programs and initiatives were implemented to educate citizens also on making wise financial choices to avoid being indebted and to seek assistance if they are already in debt. Now, what are the effects of household debt crisis? Extremely high household debt can have the potential negative effects on the strength of households as they are left with less disposable income. And also the higher the proportion of disposable income they pay towards debt, the less they will be able to save. And this leaves households vulnerable and poor. Debt also leaves less funds for investment for the whole economy. Hence, it slows economic growth, leading to unemployment and increase in poverty. Other consequences, which are quite severe, are the effect on a person's mental health, also on stress, depression, and feelings of helplessness and shamefulness. And it is very difficult for a person who is in debt to obtain obtain advantages such as home loans, new credit, and so on. So high indebtedness results also in high interest rates that a person has to pay towards that debt, high principal repayments. So this leads to decrease in standard of living and reduces consumer spending, ultimately slowing economic growth. And also this is important given that 60% of South Africa's gross domestic product comes from consumption expenditure. So given these findings, we came up with a framework for managing household debt. So this is a recommendation which, if implemented, can help to reduce the problem of household indebtedness in South Africa. So the framework has four components, and it reflects suggested measures to reduce household debt. Upskilling households is the need to upskill the households, whereby there are calls for participation by different stakeholders in maybe helping households to understand how to manage their finance, how to avoid the debt trap, and how to manage debt if they are already in debt. Then review of interest rates on debt repayment, on overdue repayments. Bank information disclosure, also very important. Vital information which may affect decision to borrow by consumers. And finally, debt insurance to cover for cases where the household faces unforeseen circumstances such as illness and disability. So these are the major recommendations that we came up with in terms of alleviating the problem of household debt in South Africa. So we conclude that mortgages constitute most of the household debt in South Africa, and there are several causes of over-indebtedness of households, which include lack of financial literacy, lack of proper protection from predatory practices of lenders. We also conclude that the increasing cost of living coupled with low household disposable income leads to low or no savings, leading to increased debt. Other causes, as I've explained, are high interest rates or other misfortunes that might befall some households. And household debt is also positively or negatively affected by educational level, gender, age, health, employment status of the household head, and also whether the household is renting, has a mortgage, or whether it receives a social security grant, and also the size of the household affect its indebtedness. And the measures to reduce the household debt problem in South Africa is indicated in the framework, upskilling households on financial literacy, review of interest rates on debt, information disclosure by money lenders, and also availability of insurance for the debtors. With this, I come to the end of my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.